Grand Prix, Acadia, Minas, and Evangeline are all names which, in their broader significance, represent many an interesting fact in the history of Nova Scotia. But the thought suggested is the banishment of a race of people from the country they had occupied for nearly 150 years. On one hand, a poet has woven into undying verse the story of that closing scene. A soldier, on the other hand, has recorded in a journal the facts and details that make up the last days of the Acadian occupation of Grand Pré. One is a poetic creation based upon the facts of history, the other a journal of a commander with an unpleasant duty to perform. However, it is up to the imagination to complete the picture, without the aid of a poet or historian, of the grief and misery that became the lot of this banished and wandering people. Chapter 1, The History of Grand Pré by John Frederick Herbin, 1898. Good day, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jerome the Gravekeeper, and welcome to the Grand Pré Heritage Barn, located just down the Old Post Road from the landscape of Grand Pré UNESCO World Heritage Site, where on Friday we had, dare I say, one of the greatest performances ever of our lucky 13 seasons of Valley Ghost Walks. Ooh, the setting sun shone spectacularly. The full moon persistently poked its face out from beyond the clouds, and a nice warm breeze slightly kept the bugs at bay. For the 19 lucky brave souls who attended, it sure was special. It makes us even more excited to replicate this magic this week, Thursday, October the 8th, 6:30 at the barn for our second ever Ghostly Bubble sit-down show featuring John Frederick Herbin and many of your other favorite family-friendly phantoms from over the years. We ask you to bring a lawn chair, bring a blanket, bring bug spray, bring your masks. Tickets are available up until noon, the day of showtime. Advance only, no walk-ups. Find them online at Ticketpro.ca or any other physical outlets up and down the valley. We truly hope to see you here. We've never been more excited for a show. You'll dig it.